Action Comics number 688, which was published in 1993, witnessed an epic confrontation between Guy Gardner and the Eradicator. This story takes place after the death of Superman in the final battle against Doomsday in Metropolis. Guy Gardner reads the news of four superheroes claiming to be the real Superman. He decides to travel to Metropolis to investigate. He remembers how Superman did not really like him, but he still respects him a lot as the only hero who managed to stop Doomsday, the monster who turned the Justice League into amateurs. He vows that nobody fake is going to call himself Superman and gets away with it. In Metropolis, the Eradicator stops a bank robber by breaking his hands, sending him to the hospital, showing that the methods he adopted to fight crime are different than those of Superman. The robber said that he did not kill anyone in his life, and that he does not deserve to be killed. The Eradicator said that he is not going to kill him, but he will make sure that he will not try this again. He broke every single bone from his fingertips to his elbows. Guy Gardner then confronted the Eradicator in some abandoned old gas station near the harbor. Believing that the Eradicator is not the real Superman, Gardner attacked and said that he does not need the Justice League or the Green Lantern's Corps to take him down. He knocked him right into the harbor, but Eradicator retaliated and knocked Gardner away with a punch. Gardner said that this punch would have taken his head off had not he protected himself with his ring. Even Lobo never hit him that hard. Eradicator attacked again and knocked Gardner down, who found himself on the ropes and realized that this Superman is no pushover. Using the power of his ring, Gardner created a golden armor to fight the powerful Superman, but Eradicator overpowered him again. They eventually came across an illegal weapons sale, where the gangsters committed a horrible mistake and opened fire on Eradicator, who decided to teach them a lesson. He crippled them the way he did to that unlucky bank's robber. Seeing how Eradicator handled the gangsters, Gardner decided to stop fighting him and said that he is the Superman he wanted to have around. Gardner said that it's good to see Superman back and wondered why he was holding back all these years. In Action Comics number 704, which was published in 1994, and following the return of the real Superman, Superman is investigating the new Superman who replaced him during his absence, to prove that he is the real one. Disturbed by the revelation that the body found in his tomb is his, Superman suspects that the Eradicator is responsible. He eventually found the Eradicator, who was leading a group of the Outsiders, and fought him. Superman said that the Eradicator is made of pure energy, so it wasn't that hard to find him. Superman wanted answers, but the Eradicator blasted him away. Superman remarked that the Eradicator is as strong and as stubborn as he is. He knocked him into a generator room, but Eradicator knocked Superman into a bank of gas cans, remarking that Superman has never been that savage or reckless before. Superman emerged from within the flames and grabbed Eradicator from the neck, removed his visor, and blasted him with his heat vision. Superman demanded to know whose body was in his tomb. He says that Cyborg is dead, and Steel and Superboy are forces for good, which leaves the Eradicator as the last one who tried to take his place. Eradicator said that he did not do what Superman thought he did, and that it is not his style. The Outsiders then decided to intervene to prevent Superman from finishing the Eradicator. Realizing that Eradicator is not responsible, Superman left the place. A recent confrontation took place in Superman Volume 4, Number 3, which was published in 2016, when the Eradicator discovered that Superman has a son. However, John is partly human, and he does not qualify as a pure-blooded Kryptonian. Therefore, he wants to bolster his Kryptonian genome by absorbing his human one. He attempts to swallow up John, but Krypto jumps between the two and gets swallowed instead. Superman takes his family into the dark side of the moon, a place that will allow him not to hold back against the Eradicator. Deep into the moon, Superman leads his family into a secret base built by Batman where they can be safe. The Eradicator knows that Superman will not use his full power against him because of the Kryptonian souls housed in his body, so he absorbs Superman and goes towards John, who attempts to fight back but his attacks are ineffective. Fortunately, Lois finds the Hellbat armor and defends her son for a while. Inside the Eradicator's body, Superman comes across all the Kryptonian souls the Eradicator has captured. The spirits agree to help Superman but warn him that there will be a great risk. Entering Superman's body, the spirits increase his power and allow him to escape into the outside world. The power-boosted Superman fights the Eradicator, who has one last Kryptonian soul left in his body. The fierce battle continues on the moon, almost destroying the Batcave. The moon's ground shakes, and the space scientists broadcast it to the whole world. Superman then helps Krypto break out of the Eradicator's body, and helps Superman destroy him. Together, they finally manage to put the powerful Eradicator down. So that was some cool fights featuring Superman, the Eradicator, and the Green Lantern. Hope you liked the video. Don't forget to subscribe, share, and like. Thanks for watching, and have a nice one.